The polar vortex is upon us, sinners. Turn up your local heat sources. Prepare for the oncoming snowpocalypse. Where did this thing come from? Hey there, cold ones. This is D News. I'm Trace. If you'd asked me about the polar vortex in 2013, I'd have assumed it was the bad guy in some new cheesy superhero show. In 2014, when a blizzard and cold system struck, for some reason it got this new catchy name, the polar vortex. It was so popular that Bloomberg joked it was the uncontested lead for buzzword of 2014. This new meteorological term was everywhere except that the polar vortex as you know it is a lie. It's not actually new. What the media dubbed the polar vortex is really just the Arctic or polar jet stream, also known as one of the westerlies or the circumpolar vortex. We've known about it for decades, though now that we have a cute term for it, we're hearing it more. You're not imagining things. I'm about to say something confusing, but trust me on this. The polar vortex is spilling out of the top of the planet, scientists think, because of global warming. Yeah, it's getting colder because it's getting warmer. It's called the warm Arctic cold continents pattern. Atmospheric science is complicated. But again, the polar vortex isn't a new thing. In January of 1985, we hit record cold temperatures, negative 34 degrees in North Carolina, paired with blizzards in the Northeast. Even Florida was affected. Then in December of 1989, another very cold, huge blizzard hit, dropping record snow and dipping the temperatures to zero, also in North Carolina. They didn't call it the polar vortex then. Instead, they referred to cross-polar flow, or the polar jet stream. Blizzards and polar air hit in 1977, 78, 82, 85, 89. In 93, they called it the storm of the century. They hit in 96 and 2008. You get it. In 2014, a bit of this jet stream shifted, allowing polar air to slosh out of the bowl on top of the planet. The jet streams and low pressure systems then were hitting the United States almost every year, thanks to this polar vortex. We just didn't call it that until 2014. Okay, so what is this thing? Here is the top of the Earth, just chilling. That is a sweet Earth, you might say. And that is the circumpolar vortex, aka the polar vortex. As the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration puts it, the jet stream is wobbling because of the circumpolar vortex. It's basically a low-pressure cold system that is held in place by the west-to-east moving jet stream. But in recent years, this oval-shaped jet stream on top of our planet has been breaking down. And it's been on this trend for decades. A study in October 2016's Nature explores how climate change is a possible cause. The warming of our planet is weakening this polar jet stream, reducing sea ice and causing this sloshing of cold air. That cold air causes the cold temperatures and, of course, this crazy winter weather. On top of that, as the jet stream changes, the polar vortex is shifting from North America to Europe and Asia. You can secretly cheer, but you'd be wrong to do so, because a weaker polar jet stream means more cold air down away from the poles, not less. It might even mean longer winters, with the polar vortex showing up in March. This stuff is really complicated. And to further complicate it, there are two polar vortices. One circumpolar vortex floats in the stratosphere, which rests 50 kilometers above the Earth, and another circumpolar vortex sits in the troposphere, between 5 and 20 kilometers. So what you're feeling on your frozen face, that's the influence of these polar winds, not necessarily the polar winds themselves. Whew, this could get chilly. Oh, and P.S., there are also polar vortices at the bottom of the planet, too. To be honest, as much as we humans love going to the beach, we can only hope that the cold air stays cold. Because if that sea ice melts, we're screwed. Global warming. Not only is it hotter, but it's colder, too. If you're wondering why winter doesn't disprove global warming, don't worry. I've got the answer for you right here. I remember cold. That's probably why I have a mop top of hair in that video. How do you guys feel about the media blowing up these winter norms? Tell us about it down in the comments. Make sure you come back here every day for more D News, and thanks for watching.